The next two side battles go incredibly well. In this battle, river crossing, I try a crossing on the left side for the first time ever. Well, actually, what I did in a previous game that was not recorded in another playthrough I did, another campaign, is I tried to cross, well, I went up to the river on the left side, and I was able to bait the enemy into the river, and they attacked over and over again into the river, and then stood in the river, where they got slaughtered, and it was a very easy battle, and I think I lost like 1,500 guys total. It was a real bloodbath. I couldn't get that to happen this time. So I spend a good 25 minutes just trying to bait the enemy into the river. I do get them to attack some, but no matter what I do, they're just not having it. They're just not going to commit to attacking over and over and over again. So at some point I have to go after them, and I decide to cross on the left side because by that time I've weakened them pretty substantially. The attack goes fairly well. And one of the reasons I attack on the left is, well, I've never done it before. Even when I slaughtered the enemy on the left side, I still attacked, crossed the river on the right side. But the problem I have is I've never wiped the enemy out in this battle. And I think maybe if I attack on the left side, I'll be able to wipe the enemy out entirely for the first time. And that would be fun. So that's what I do. And in this battle, I do get them all. So for the first time, other people have told me that they've managed to get them all by attacking on the right side and just being very careful not to take the flag on the left side because it sets off a countdown timer. I've never been able to do that. I always run out of time. But in this battle, I get them. I'm very happy with the results. Every unit gets a star. All my green units come out with their first star. Two of my artillery units get their second star. Every unit has a good day, except for one 1842 unit, which only got 2-1. The overall battle is just better than 4, maybe 4.5-1. Something like that. But the real story isn't the 4-1. The real story is that every unit comes out with a bunch of experience and every unit did really well. The units I really wanted to do well did the best. I wanted my artillery units to get a bunch of experience. I really want that second star. I need my snipers to get their first star as quickly as possible. Because, of course, I'm building up for the next grand battle. And as well as this battle went, the side battle after this one is just goes so incredibly well. I was shocked. I had almost so few casualties and easily wiped out the entire enemy force. And at the end of both of these battles, my army is really, I'm really happy with it. I'm really happy with the level of experience it has and so on. And my army's in great shape. So watch the rest of the battle. I hope you enjoy it. The important thing, of course, is what happens in camp. And camp is going to start to get more and more interesting as the army gets bigger. So, and then about the time of Antietam, it gets really interesting. Please enjoy the rest of the battle, and I'll see you in camp.
Or mine!